You guys, you'll know. Oh, you'll know. You'll know when you see me. That's right. That's right. You'll see how it is. That's exactly what I'm talking about. I'm talking about respect. I'm talking about love. That's right. That's right. I love you people. But you don't love me. Listen to me. Listen. You don't hear what I'm saying. Now hear me out. Now hear me out. I'm trying to say that you don't know who I am. You don't know. You never listen to me. Now listen. Now just shut up and listen. I'm telling you for your own good. I have all the time in the world. All the time in the world. You just listen. There was a time when I was planning to live forever, but I have found it necessary to change those plans. Yours, very truly, George Raymond Solway.
Drink my coffee, stand it up, smile and speak straight. turn and walk away. This is a tough, cold city, and I guess I'll never cut it here. And I'm so tired of trying to stand against it all alone. This is the last morning, and I'm gonna have to fight it. I'm going home.
Cannot entirely rule out the possibility at this point that you are a bird.
A what?
A bird, Mr. Salloway. A winged flying bird.
What kind of bird?
A loony bird, Mr. Salloway. A crazy Nazi loony bird.
Doc, baby.
Hello? Yeah?
Hey, Mandrake, it's me.
Yeah.
It's me, Georgie, your highest paying crazy head.
Yes, hello, Mr. Salloway. How are you?
7 years, and you don't know how I am yet.
Mr. Salloway, you have not appeared for your last 5 sessions. Once again, Mr. Salloway, we have the conflict between your deep
and the buggy told the seal to go walking out to
Mr. Salloway. Mr. Salloway, you are singing.
Come back to you, give me some.
Oh, old friend of destruction pattern again. You need to undermine the authority of those you respect. Right. To destroy the credentials of those
you
trust.
Here's a world of sunshine waiting for me.
Mr. Salloway, you are singing.
On the other side.
Number 8 on the charts, Doc. Climbing like a son of a bitch.
That is not what you called to tell me about, is it, Mr. Salloway?
6 nights, Dr. Oz. No sleep. Look at my face. The inside is worse. Midgets in there having a picnic. Chomping on my brains. Sleep! Wear my pajamas all day, just in case it comes. Like party clothes in case of an invitation.
No sleep at all, Mr. Sullivan?
Some. Not good. Gotta see you right away, honey.
Mr. Sullivan, your regular appointment is tomorrow.
Well, my life is happening to me now.
Sorry, Mr. Sullivan, your regular appointment is
Doc,
tomorrow.
I gotta see you. My marbles, Doc, they are spilling. They are rolling out onto the floor and behind the refrigerator, but you can't get at them anymore.
Very well, Mr. Sullivan. Can you be here immediately?
Beauty, baby. I'm buying you Vienna for your birthday. I'm off to see the wizard. Here he is, the wonderful wizard. Ever is there once. I'm off to see.
I got him. He's here, Georgie. You flip out, this is it, Georgie, the voice, the heart breaks.
Untouched purity, 100%. Breaks the heart. Great group name, now we put shades on them and we have one blind mouse. Now we get two other mice and what do you got? Three blind mice, you get it? Beautiful. Now you make one demo album and you get 80% of the void. Okay, three blind mice, forget it, mistake, I hate it. We put a dress on him and call him it.
Roses, beauty, take them, roses here. Beauty, beauty, get him here, come on, take the roses. Come on, take them, roses here, beauty, get your roses. Come on, beauty's here, roses, get your roses.
I never carry any money.
You're blocking the stand, Pat.
Please, trust me. I'll pay you later. $10. Look. You see this picture? That's me, Georgie Soloway. I live right up there on top of the General Motors.
Good, good. I live on the Chandelier Radio City Music Hall. Give me the book back or I'll call a cop.
Please, I gotta have it.
Hey, look, you rotten hippie. You goddamn magic.
How you feeling, Doc?
Good.
Almost lost my axe today.
Sweet old axe.
Sweet old axe. A lot of good sounds, a lot of heavy sounds come out of this axe. 61 songs this year. Not counting two-piece marches, a cigarette commercial, four Christmas ballads and the new Air Force hymn, cancer jingle. A lot of good songs left in this axe, right? Right, Doc? Hey. Look at that. Voice of the people. How do you like that? Songs of love, Solly. Can't love anybody this year without using Georgie's words. Everybody banging a Georgie's beat. Finger on the pulse, eye on the sparrow. Everybody loving Solly's style. Christ's sake, Doc, I nearly killed myself getting in that magazine. The least you could do
Mr.
is...
Mr. Soloway, you referred earlier on the telephone to an emergency, a crisis.
Mr. Soloway, Christ's sake, I mean, 7 years and you're still calling me Mr. Soloway. Aren't we buddies yet?
Fine, then. Now tell me what's wrong, George.
Good. There's a fellow who wants to kill me, Sal. Fellow, I don't know who it is. I mean, you're not a paranoid if everybody really does hate you, right? Now, we've established that I'm ready to be loved. I mean, it's years getting me ready for that number. And I'm really ready to love myself and commit myself to another human being now. And I'm really ready to love and commit myself to another human being now because I've learned to love myself and forgive myself for how rotten I am. That is where we're at. That is the scene, right?
Well, that's not exactly...
I mean, it cost me $52,560. Not counting cab fares. And a lot of years so you could sell me back to myself. And now I'm supposed to be straight on this love thing. And now an outside force, a big gun from out of town, a person is screwing it up. You got that? Some rat calling himself Harry Kellerman is calling up every chick I see and telling lies about me, giving me the bad mouth all over town. Sal, please, talk to me. I mean, who would hate me so much? Doc, what do you think? What should I do? I don't...
Don't tell me your troubles. I got troubles of my own. Don't tell me your troubles. Just leave me alone. Leave me alone. Sweet love left you. Well, what you think about me? I've got those same old heartbreaks, the same old miseries. Leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
Oh, oh, oh. Headed to a friend.
Cut it out!
What is it, George? What is wrong, George?
Doc. Doc, it is cookie jar time. It's time to put me in the cookie jar.
Cookie jar?
I mean, in New York State, cookie jar busting. Doc, certain things have been happening. I mean, I see a lot of shows that aren't listed. I mean, they are not in the TV guide, so. Last couple nights, I get a hold of Chomsky. We drive around in my limo. I think if I'm moving, I can sleep, see? Started thinking about King Lear last night. Old cat in the floor slipping out. Shakespeare's a winner, man. Those sonnets. Geez, the right music, I tell you, they'd all be in the top 10. King Lear, see? Alone in the forest. He looks up in the sky and he says, oh God, let me not be mad. Getting crazy. Help me. Help me, old wizard, for I lie busted in the yellow brick road. Christ's sake, say something, will you? Isn't this your table? I want service.
Come on, Ringo. Earn your 50. Calmly, George. It is clearly the Kellerman problem and the resulting lack of sleep. Your dreams seek other stages on which to play. Our attempt here, of course, must be to embrace reality, to welcome it.
Why? Why should I do anything for reality? It never done nothing for me.
You'll have to continue tomorrow, George.
Not tomorrow. Now.
George, I have waiting outside for me another patient.
Not yet. Give me another hour. I'll buy off your next nut. Stick with me today. There's an extra grand in it for you.
It's 45 cents for the first 1/6 of a mile. 10 cents for each additional 1/3 of a mile thereafter. You require for special out-of-town rates. I have here a prescription for sleeping pills, George.
Pills? Pills? I come to you in flames and you treat me for sunburn.
It is essential that you sleep tonight.
All I need is my songs, you and your goddamn pills. Doctor, I'm sorry, but you've just lost your top crazy head. Sweetheart, the Viennese waltz is over.
Invincible. Don't. Yeah, hello, yeah.
Hello, it's Sally.
Sally, darling, crazy. Much.
Georgie, you sound out of breath.
Exercise, live, forever. Hey,
Georgie,
Sally, come on.
I just now had a terrible experience.
Yeah?
Guy calls me up, says he's a friend of yours, says you have a wife, 2 children, several social diseases, and just got out of Payne Whitney Clinic, where they put you for behaving in a violent manner.
Who said that?
Oh,
my
well,
God.
He says his name is Harry Kellerman. A friend, an ex-friend of yours, says that's all you have is ex-friends because of how sooner or later you behave in a violent manner. He seems to know you very well.
Kill him.
Georgie.
Fine, kill him.
Georgie, you sound like you're about to behave in a violent manner.
Sally!
The thing is, Georgie, I gotta go to work soon. I only called to tell you.
Sally, wait a minute.
It's actually very late. I have to go now.
Sally, wait.
It's actually very late.
I'll see you tonight.
Tonight? Actually, I better just get to sleep early tonight.
Hey, Sally.
It's very late.
Sally, you know me.
I don't really know you. I've only slept with you.
Sally, wait. Sally. Hey.
Well, Bunky told Lucille.
Yeah, what did he say, love? What did he say?
He said, go walking out in rain.
Oh, man.
And he said, do not come back.
What?
Until you bring me a little something.
Yeah, like what?
Like to put up in my vein one more round. Georgie Porgy, George Soloway, who wrote this song and many other great songs out there. Throw a light on. Georgie Soloway, let's get him up here. Give him a hand.
Bernie.
1,700 paid admissions at 60%, Joe.
Other side.
Georgie, this is hostile behavior. Like, I mean, you could consider my goddamn dignity.
Baby!
Like, you always call me after midnight, and like, I always come over. But I don't want you to think that you can just always... Oh, Georgie. Georgie. It's been so long.
Oregon, 76371. Susan. Susan. Do you still love me?
Yes, I do, Georgie. No, but we'll the thing them. Is, Georgie, I mean, like, do you love me?
I'll get you a drink on top of the world, right?
Georgie, I'm concerned about our relationship.
Come on.
Georgie, do you think I'm dumb?
What do you mean?
Do you go around telling people that you think I'm dumb? This fella, you know, he called me, and he said...
Kelvin.
He said that you told him that you thought I was dumb, and that the only reason you see me is to...
I'll kill him!
Is it true? Is that really what you tell
none
people,
of,
George?
None of it is true!
I think I better go.
Wait,
now.
Wait, Susan, come on!
This has not been a pleasant evening.
Hey, come on, Susan. Hey, Susan, don't leave.
And don't call me so late anymore.
Don't leave, not tonight. I need you here.
Like goodbye, Georgie.
Susan, the people I called after 12 are the most important people. In the wee hours, Susan, in those small, enormous hours!
Oh, 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 this Harry Kelly man. Oh, he does such a thing to his fellow man. Yeah, five chicks and he gave them all chicks. Wants me alone and he wants me single. Who's that cat?
That's Killer Man. Calls himself Harry Kelly Man. Single. Even old Oregon, born up here in heaven. And even old Oregon seven.
That's what.
There we go. Our places, everybody, please. Please, closer together. That's it. Kachiku, kachiku.
Is it what you want, Georgie?
What do you mean?
Be married, Georgie.
What do you mean? What?
Be married, Georgie.
Sure. Perfect. Forever, Glory.
Music is a mountain.
Come on, baby. Star Spangled Banner, anything.
Red hair and lime green sweaters. A candy store of a girl. I used to have the cleanest sneakers that you ever saw. I was 18 and I knew how to live forever. Goodbye to goodbye, farewell to farewell. I'm staying right here with you. Don't you worry, because I never would get you. Goodbye to traveling with sorrow. Hello, see you tomorrow.
See this couch, Ruthie? This is a fold-out couch. Oh. And it won't fold out. That's the unfortunate thing.
Oh.
I'm trying to fix it. That's why I'm under it. You okay?
Yes, fine. Well, actually, I'm cold.
Oh, look. There's a blanket on the couch.
How's it going?
Well, it seems to be something with the spring. You okay?
Yes. It's just that I was scared for a moment because when I came out of the bathroom, nobody was here. For a second, I thought you'd gone away.
I didn't go away. I'm right here. I'm really very sorry about this. This is a very unfortunate thing. This never happened before. Usually just folds out.
Oh.
Usually just folds right out.
Have you folded it out a lot?
Huh?
The couch, I mean. Have there been a lot of people who you folded
well,
out
you
for?
Know, I mean,
oh, listen, that's all right.
People come and I fold it
that's
out.
That's all right.
That's the way it goes.
Of course. Georgie, the ceiling is coming down.
Huh?
The ceiling is coming down.
Oh.
Big chunks of it. That was another one.
I'm really very sorry about this. This never happened before.
Here comes another one. It's really coming down a lot, Georgie.
I better fix this first, and then I'll come out and look at the ceiling.
Okay. But it's really coming down. Georgie? Really a lot of people? Girls, I mean, many, many.
Well, you know.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to ask. I was hoping not many, many, just some. Really coming down. Plaster everywhere. And I've never made love to anybody before.
Nobody?
No, not anybody. And now the ceiling is coming down, and the couch won't fold out, and I'll get pregnant. So the ceiling will fall on my head and I will be dead.
Ruthie, the reason why this couch doesn't fold out is because I never folded it out before. I've only slept on it alone. Alone and unfolded. I want you to know that. Ruthie, if this lovemaking thing is so terrific, then how come I fixed this couch 5 minutes ago? And I'm still lying here under it with my old socks.
Georgie, can I come under there with you? Because I think the ceiling is going to kill me.
Yes, of course.
Hello.
Hello.
Ruthie, I love you.
You don't have to.
I know I don't have to, but I do.
Well, that's good. Because I love you too, Georgie.
Forever, Ruthie? Always?
Yes, Georgie, forever. Always. Hold me, Georgie. Hold me. Georgie, hold me. The sky is falling. The sky is falling.
I'm singing goodbye to goodbye, farewell to farewell. I'm staying right here with you. Don't you worry, because I never would. Goodbye to traveling with sorrow. Hello to see you tomorrow. Singing this sweet forever song. Forever, forever. Used to be a daydream weaver. Used to be a lover and a leaver. But now that's all behind me. You'll be right here to remind me. This time it's forever after. So I'm shouting it from the rafters. Singing this sweet forever singing. Believe you never singing. My sweet forever song. Forever, forever.
I love your songs.
Forever.
They make me cry.
Forever. Ruthie, just you and writing my song. That's all I need in the world. Jesus, school. I haven't shown for a month.
Neither is my period. I thought I'd better tell you.
Don't worry, honey.
What does that mean?
Don't worry about a thing, honey.
What does that mean?
Oh, boy. Harry Truman makes me nervous. Oh, boy.
Georgie, Danny Ackerman.
Who?
Leon, Danny Ackerman.
Who?
Danny Ackerman. It's hot.
Here we are, Doctor. 724 Ocean Avenue, the home of the brave. On the floor below us is their restaurant, Leon's Ports of Call, where occupancy by more than 42 people is dangerous, unlawful, and highly unlikely. Here they are, Doctor. Here they are as they have always been. My father is dreaming of a larger restaurant, and my mother is reading the obituaries. My father's had trouble talking to me since the day he noticed I was taller than he was. You will notice that he talks directly to my chest, which is where my head used to be when I was 12.
Georgie, look at this. Scarlatti's Cafe, Neptune Avenue, my competition. 40 tables. Can you imagine, Georgie? Can you imagine what they take in there one night, a place like that?
Danny Ackerman, Leon, you know from the Democratic Club.
Oh, yeah. What about him?
On his way to the airport yesterday, his heart. In the taxicab, no warning, perfect health in a taxicab. It's hard, on the way to Cleveland, Ohio, on business.
Danny Ackerman? I don't believe it.
Life is here, life is over.
Pop, Ma, there are certain decisions which I have reached about not going to school to be a musicologist, and...
Danny Ackerman, we just saw him.
On the beach, running in place.
Running, jumping, swimming.
And about this girl and marriage and writing songs, and I...
It's a young man. He couldn't have been more than what?
64, 65.
Pops! Topsy, Ma! I'll tell you why I came home this morning.
To eat.
Now, Leon, it's his birthday. For what other occasion would he leave his gorgeous garret, where God knows what's going on?
His birthday. Happy birthday, Georgie.
19 years old. He's playing an out-of-tune piano in a nightclub with God
it's
knows...
It's not a nightclub. It's a kind of restaurant.
Out-of-tune piano is a sin to the ears. Happy birthday, Georgie.
19 years old. Look at the face on that kid. The intelligence in the eyes, Margo.
There's something I wish to discuss with you both, frankly.
Those are not 19-year-old eyes, Margo.
First, about school.
What about school, Georgie? What's up?
Well, I wanted to tell you both together.
Hello, Blanche?
Tell me. I got to go to the restaurant.
Blanche, Danny Ackerman.
What is it, Georgie?
Danny Ackerman, you know, from the Democratic Club.
Needs money?
No money, Pop.
It's hard, Blanche. Well, on the way to Cleveland, Ohio. Yeah.
What is it, Georgie?
Some things.
What is it? You got somebody pregnant? You quit school? What?
Yes.
Yes, what? What yes?
Both.
Both what?
Both of what you just said.
What did I just say? What? Oh, boy. You quit school and somebody's pregnant?
Right.
Oh, boy.
Well, I wanted to...
Don't tell your mother. She won't understand.
So I'm...
Somebody you want to get married to?
Well, I was thinking, maybe
I... have to. I know a doctor in New Jersey. I'll fix it.
Really?
Both waitresses at the restaurant, they're on a shuttle practically to New Jersey.
The thing is, Pop, I was thinking
you
maybe...
Tell your mother, I'll kill you. She won't understand. She lives with your Aunt Blanche on Mars. Sister Phyllis had an abortion her last year in her to college.
I didn't know that. Phyllis?
Shh. Tell your mother I'll kill you.
Phyllis?
What about school? You don't want to be in... what do you call
it? A musicologist. No, I don't think so, Papa.
What would you like better?
I don't know. Writing songs, maybe. I don't.
We're having dinner at Phyllis's tonight. You look funny at your sister, I'll kill you.
I won't.
Leon, Lance wants to talk to you.
Come tonight. After the dinner rush, we'll work it out.
I told Blanche to keep him on the phone. You got a girl pregnant, right?
Well, I...
Boyd Garrett's in nightclubs. I know a doctor in New Jersey. Don't worry.
Really?
It's good enough for Phyllis. Don't worry.
Phyllis?
Tell your father I'll break your neck. He doesn't know the world outside of the restaurant.
Okay.
After he leaves for work tonight, we'll talk. Arrangements. But young, Georgie, don't worry. Don't worry, you'll be free.
You okay, Ruthie?
Yeah. It's just that I thought we'd get married, Georgie.
Yeah, me too. But see, with school and everything...
Okay.
The thing is, when I finish school...
You love me, Georgie?
Sure I do. Now, don't worry. There's a doctor,
It's okay. I told my sister. She got me this doctor in New Jersey.
Oh.
I gotta go now. I told my sister I'd be home by supper. She worries a lot now.
Oh.
I'll be in New Jersey a couple of days, Georgie.
Uh-huh.
Will you wait for me, Georgie?
Sure.
Sometimes I think...
I can't hear you, Lucy.
I think sometimes you never got out from under that couch.
Hey, Doc. Ruthie Trash. Pretty, pretty Ruthie Trash. Red hair and lime green sweaters. Heard she got married to a neurologist and lives in Forest Hills. Where the sky never falls.
Hello, good morning, how are you? This is a machine speaking to you. When you hear the machine go beep beep, you will please leave your name, your telephone number, and your message.
Beep beep. Right, gotcha, Doc. That's the clearest thing you said to me in 7 years.
Georgie. Georgie, baby. We're here. We love you. Oh, Georgie. Georgie, we're here. We love you. Right, Lemuel?
Love.
What are you doing here? How'd you get in here?
In the wings of joy, Georgie. In the wings of joy and happiness.
Joy.
What the hell are you doing here?
Well, you said to come, Georgie. Your production manager called, said you wanted to talk about a demo with my boy.
What production manager?
Kellerman, he said.
Marty, go away.
Georgie, look at these contracts.
Away, Marty, go away.
Humiliation, Georgie.
Marty, 100%. Marty, I want you out of here.
He really doesn't like white singers. It's not your fault.
Goddamn
racist.
Princess,
white is beautiful.
Marty, get out of here! Get out of here!
You're crazy, Soloway. Look at you. You're crazy. He told me about you. You're crazy.
A loony bird, Mr. Salovey. A crazy Nazi loony bird.
Somebody. Gotta talk to somebody. Who's around? Who's up? Who do I know? Hey, my old buddy. Yeah.
Yellow, Midtown.
Hey, Midtown Drugs. How the hell are you, Midtown Drugs?
Oh, Mr. Soloway.
Yeah, send me an overdose of anything.
Well, it'd be tonight, Mr. Soloway.
Reason for living? Some bubble bath and a comb.
Mr. Soloway, we're kind of busy here. There's nothing I can send you.
Matter of fact, I need a shave. I could use some shaving equipment.
Fine, what'll it be? Blades, razor, cream?
First thing I'm gonna need is a face. You can't shave without a face. Midtown, send me a face.
Free as a bird in the sky, free as a cloud rolling by.
Hey, Gloria, come out on the terrace. The sun is shining, it's terrific.
I'm reading the papers, Georgie.
Free as may roll.
Well, what's the connection between reading the papers and not coming out on the terrace, Gloria?
I'm just reading the papers, Georgie.
Free as may roll by. In my Pontiac.
What's the point of us having this big, beautiful terrace with sun pouring onto it if you're never going to use it, Gloria?
I use the terrace, Georgie.
And all the time we've been here, you've never been out on the terrace. Will you tell me why is that?
Just because we have a terrace is no reason that I have to feel obligated to that terrace to be out on it all the time.
I'm not asking you to sleep on the terrace or live on the terrace, Gloria. I'm just asking you to come out and read the papers with me on it.
Free as a bird rolling by.
Gloria, I'm going to ask you once more to come out on this terrace, because I know that you will love and enjoy being on this terrace. You could probably get a nice sunburn. And I'm going to drop the subject.
Free as me rolling by.
Would really be a pleasant way to spend the afternoon, Gloria, believe me. Gloria, please come out on the terrace. There's iced coffee out here for you.
Okay, here I am.
Good. Want some iced coffee?
No, thank you. Georgie, did you marry me because I was pregnant?
Huh?
I was just in there and I started to cry in the newspapers. And I wondered if you married me because I was pregnant.
Christ's sake, Gloria, that was 10 years ago.
12, did you?
12 years ago and you're just asking me now?
I always meant to ask you.
Christ's sake, Gloria, I mean, why all of a sudden now?
Because last night when you made love to me, you called me Sandra. And 2 months ago, you called me Jan. And since you're making love to me is a rare enough occasion, I just wish you'd at least get my name straight. Because you were in California on business for at least 6 months this year. And when you are here, your eyes never look into mine. And suddenly before, I started to cry all over the magazine section, and I wondered if you married me because I was pregnant.
I married you because I loved you, Gloria.
And now?
And now I got this problem. It's not you. It's nothing personal. I got this problem about time. See, it's like this house is full of time.
I was sitting in there thinking about when you were playing piano at the Paradise Cafe. I was waiting on tables a year before you noticed me.
Time keeps going by. I keep thinking, how come I got 2 kids and I feel like I'm only 18?
One night we're closing up and I found you asleep on the piano bench. So I covered you up with a checkered tablecloth.
It's nothing personal, see, but our kids, those goddamn kids, they keep kicking at me like clocks.
Who are you? And I said, Gloria DeCheco. I've been watching you sleep.
It's like goddamn clocks, those kids.
That was 12 years ago. Sometimes at night, I still watch you sleep.
I get terrified.
Forever, you said. Forever and always. So when you were away last month, I went to speak to Arnie. I mean, I had to talk about this to somebody. You know how he is when he listens, good old Arnie. He keeps puffing on that cigar. I talked to him all night. And then I slept with him. I don't understand how I could do that, Georgie. I started thinking I was crazy. I mean, I love being married to you. I love you. I even like laundry. What do you think, Georgie? Do you think I'm crazy? Did you hear what I told you?
Sure. You want some iced coffee?
No, thank you.
What would you like?
A divorce.
Fast.
Short and sweet. Oh, wow-wee, baby.
For a couple of seconds.
Wow-wee, baby.
Hey, listen, is this thing really legal? It's hard to believe. Is this any good?
Sure it's good. You betcha, baby. That's it. I stamped the old seal on there, kid, and it's over for good. That's it, baby. Forever, always, you're free.
Somebody else must have called. Look again, darling.
There's no point in looking again. There's nothing for you, F-18.
Merry Christmas, ho-ho. Merry Christmas, you nutsy person, ho-ho.
Dr. Moses, what? Dr. Moses, why are you dressed like that? That's crazy.
You with the cowboy hat? You call me crazy? Okay, Charlie, what do you want for Christmas?
But it's only July.
Sure, July, Christmas. Why not? Boy, you're some crazy person, Charlie.
Georgie, my name is Georgie.
Your name is Charlie. And Christmas is in July, wacko.
Dr. Moses,
Don't argue with me what's crazy. I know crazy, and you're crazy. I got now hanging around with me eight fellas who think they're reindeers. So I got no time for you, fruitcake. Busy, busy, busy. Every place is craziness. So quick, what do you want for Christmas, Charlie?
I'd like a new life and a day without fear.
Oh, that's a shame. I got you a choo-choo train.
But I don't want it.
Rise up, Charlie. Take the choo-choo.
But I want it. I want...
Okay, Charlie, that's it. No more presents for you.
Wait.
No more presents for you, booby.
Samantha?
What are we going to do now, Sydney?
Grown-ups are going to talk, and you're going home.
Oh, but Sydney, you promised.
I lie a lot.
But you said...
Never listen to what I say. Now, come on, you tuck yourself into a taxi, because I have to talk to Georgie. Here, come on.
Georgie, he's the one who wrote...
A taxi, Samantha. Those are the yellow cars with the lights on top. Samantha, you are very good at arriving, but you leave badly. Now, you be a good girl. And I'll take you to Thailand for the weekend. Taxi! Taxi! Samantha, in New York, there are no more dragons left to slay, so... I shot you a taxi. Good night. Good morning. We leave for Thailand Friday.
Samantha, darling, you're leaving beautifully. Departure excellent.
Oh, Georgie, a dum-dum, a ding-dong. Her head belongs in a crackerjack box and a rat's in the loo. Where is it, Georgie? Tell me. Where is the right combination? I shall have to screw every attractive girl within the limits of the city of New York. It's a dirty job, Georgie, but somebody's got to do it. Lovely outfit, Georgie. You look terrible.
Oh, Jesus. Wow. Glad to see you. I gotta talk to you.
I came as soon as I got your message.
Message?
Yeah. Emergency? Crash dive? Red alert?
Right. This Kellerman thing is getting worse.
Don't worry, man. I figure he's doing you a service, getting rid of the losers. It's time you put together a new stable anyway.
No sleep, Sid. No sleep. Maybe I better call my doctor again.
Oh, come, you and that doc. Docs are taking over the world. Blessed are the docs, for they shall inherit the meek. I know what you need, Georgie. Now, for inspiration, let us turn to the good book.
No, it ain't gonna help.
Let us see what we got here. We got Susan sometimes.
Split.
Sometimes Susan never fails.
She split.
She split? Now, wait a minute. It's Stony Joni. Stony Joni's on the scene.
Not tonight.
P.P. Georgie. Ping Pong Julie. Ping Pong Julie. Tall, nutsy eyes. True love, my darling man. It's all in the book. The love book. You got the pre-dawn crazies, and true love is the answer. Now, let's get down.
I want to talk to you.
The chick from the audition. Did you score there?
Allison.
Right.
You know, she's really a lovely girl.
Yeah? Well, let me give you the word on Allison. What? The chick's a grabber.
She's not.
No, I see it in her eyes. With the raiding party. She lies in wait for the walking wounded and grabs off the strays.
But you don't know her, Sid. This one's different.
Georgie, the chick's a grabber. I tell you true.
But tonight, you know, I've been thinking about getting older, about how much time I got coming.
Georgie, listen to me. How many hits we write together? 22, babe?
21.
21 golden beauties. 3 this year alone. Georgie, this city is ours. And we're still young. We're young, Giorgio. Allison's and Allison's to go. Georgie, do not make funeral arrangements until you're dead. Oh, I've seen the way these Allisons operate. It's Rose P.M., man. It's the reign of terror. She's just looking to cop a basket full of heads.
Sid, if they're mostly losers, when are you going to know when a winner shows up? I mean, why not?
I am Baron von Richthofen, and I am flying over enemy territory. When I go down, it'll be an ace who gets me.
I don't know, Sid.
Speaking about planes, what happened to the flying Tuesday? You were supposed to give me a call.
Oh, well, see, Allison and me, I took her up in the plane. I'm sorry, I should have called.
Right. Splitting time. 3:45, I got some quality Swedish merchandise flying in.
Stewardess?
Yeah, air freight. Can't be beat for speed and reliability.
Well, I won't keep you then.
You bet you won't.
Okay, so long.
Hey, friend.
Yeah?
Watch the skies. I repeat, watch the skies for low-flying starlings. They ruin the motor.
I'll watch out, Sid.
I tell you true, sir.
Enough to listen. Give us courage to go on when we are in doubt. A
Wait a second, hey.
Thanks for calling.
Wait a second, you didn't give me the word.
I enjoy praying with you.
Give me the word.
Goodbye.
Give me the goddamn word.
Okay, what is it? Georgie, what do you want?
Irwin, bunny, how are you?
Oh, no. Georgie, it's 4:30 in the morning, Georgie.
How's the most adorable accountant in the world?
I am so sleepy.
Irwin and Marcy.
Oh.
Fine organization. Surely Irwin and Marcy shall follow me all
the days.
Georgie,
what do you want?
Irwin, you're losing the weight. You don't look well.
I can't get any sleep.
Sleep is important.
You keep waking me up 4 times already this week. Emergency crisis come right over. You understand that?
No sugar. I thought we should talk.
About what?
Business. Let's talk business. Irwin, let's buy something. Irwin, wake up. Let's make out a big check.
Oh.
Irwin. You know, you don't look well. I'm concerned.
I'm sleepy, Georgie.
Irwin, are you my friend?
I'm your accountant, Georgie.
Irwin, my friend. Let's buy this building.
Tonight? The whole building?
Now, this week.
Oh, Georgie. To consider a venture like that, you have to reevaluate.
What?
Your expenses, Georgie. The planes, those incredible gifts, and of course the women.
You know all about me.
I get the bills.
The bills, the confessions, like a priest. Please, Irwin, stay away. Do you have any children?
Gee.
I didn't even know you were married. 16 years, I never asked you. You must hate me. What's your wife's name?
Marcia.
Would you like a drink?
No, thank you. I just
Marcia,
got up.
Marcia, do you love her?
Of course, yes.
You love me?
Georgie, I'm your accountant. It's not a matter of love or hate.
No, wrong. Everything. It's all a matter of love and hate. What's wrong with you? Don't you understand about life? Don't you listen to my songs? I'm shouting. Forgive me. Irwin, have a drink. Irwin, wake up. Just stay awake. You know everything about me. What do you think about me?
I don't really.
16 years. You must have some opinion.
Oh, Georgie, it's 4:30 in the morning,
it's
Georgie.
It's the longest
please.
Continuous relationship I got with anybody.
Georgie, please.
You gotta be my friend after
Georgie,
all this time.
Georgie, of course. Georgie.
You don't approve of my women. You see, I'm still relatively young.
Hey, there's no need to explain.
As an older man, you don't realize.
Hey, I'm only 10 months older than you, George.
I haven't slept for days. Did you bring a quarterly earnings report?
Oh, no. Not again.
Just read it to me, Irwin. It's the only way I can sleep.
It's the fourth time this week.
Once more, Bunny. Those nice warm numbers.
It's crazy, Georgie.
Please, 10 minutes.
Okay. For just a few minutes.
Pops used to sing me to sleep.
Oh, it's quite mad.
Georgie, Porgy, Ram, Ram, Ram.
Horizons Unlimited quarterly earnings report, including fees for individual assigned compositions, airplay tabulations, and mechanicals per title. Page 1. Installment payments accrued to total fees. Third payment, U.S. government for Coast Guard National Anthem, Guardians of Our Shores, $11,850.
Gloria. What's the trouble? Huh? I've been sending the checks regular.
Who's that?
Gloria, it's me, Georgie, your loving ex.
Georgie, how are you?
I'm knocking myself off.
Oh, Georgie, please, these are my people. I'm working this crowd.
No, Gloria, I drew these fans. You're doing my number. This is my material. I'm going over very big here.
Oh, Georgie, you're going to ruin this for me like everything else.
Gloria, do you still love me? Hear you, Gloria. Sorry to drop in on you like this, Doc, but I just had the worst night of my life. I close my eyes and I'm falling. Just falling. What do you think, Doctor? What does it mean?
I think you got devils in your head.
Huh?
Yes, man, you got the devil in the head. But devils come in the blood, we got to get them out. You go to Lake, man. You get the codfish.
Mm-hmm.
Put the fish on your head. Take all the bad devils out of the blood.
Codfish?
Oh, yes, the fish, man.
I want to try that.
The fish take out all the bad devils.
What about this Kellerman thing, Doctor?
The hour is up now, man.
Yeah, I just want to...
The hour is up now, man.
Yeah, but, Doctor, this...
Daylight come and me one go home.
Hey, one second, Doctor.
Oh, dale, man.
This Kellerman thing, see, I can't...
Dale, man. Dale me, banana.
You can't talk now, huh?
Daylight come and me one go home.
God damn, Moses.
We gotta find him. Chomsky?
Yes, sir.
Tonight?
Yes, sir.
Don't I'm sure I'm about to die. If you can't help me live a little longer, won't you help me go out high one more ride? Don't do all I ask is one more. World of sunshine waiting for me. Now Bunk is in a pine box in the burying yard.
Like that song, Chomsky?
Yes, sir.
Number 8 on the singles chart and climbing like an eagle. Any requests?
No, sir.
Oh.
else.
Chomsky, you remember that girl from the audition?
Sir?
You drove us around last week, remember?
Many young ladies back there, sir.
No, this one you would remember. She was quite lovely. A little older than the others.
Hello. Sorry, I was late. I'm late.
Can I sing for us now?
Yes, sing, yes.
Or we can just chat for a while.
Chat, great. Let's chat for a while. Great.
Tell us what you've been up to, lady.
Up to.
Tell us what you've been doing here.
Doing?
Would you consider yourself primarily a singer or an actress or what?
An amnesia victim. Fellas, either you're in my nightmare or I'm in yours.
Darling, what would you like to do?
Leave. I'm sorry, I can't do these auditions. I have to leave now. Filters can be fun. I just remembered. That's the last thing I did. A commercial. I had fun with a filter. Green Mist cigarettes. We finished chatting now? I think I'm finished chatting now, Mr. Halloran.
All chicks. This is an old loony chick. I tell you, Georgie, the name of the show is Now. Now, you get it, babies. I'm not handing over Now music to yesterday's chicks.
Would you like to sing now, Linda?
Yes,
Linda. Did you bring your accompanist with you?
No, nobody. No. No one.
Do you have the sheet?
Yeah, got that. You bet.
Just hand it right over there.
Shock, dear, where?
Right down the bin.
Ah, ghosts. This place is full of ghosts. Oh, piano. There's a piano down there. Well, this is a very, very old song. Now is not a good title for me. Your show was called Last Tuesday, or maybe 1957. I had a very good year and a good summer, especially in 1957, I remember. That's what I was going to do, is relax and sing, Pete. When I pretend I'm gay, I never feel that way. I'm only painting the clouds with sunshine.
Tomorrow, babies.
When I hold back a tear to make a smile appear.
Georgie, it's hopeless.
I'm only painting the clouds with sunshine.
Georgie.
Painting the blues, beautiful hues, colored with gold and old rose. Playing the clown, trying to drown all of my woe.
Linda, thank you.
Though things may not look bright, they'll all turn out all right.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Snyder.
The best part was just coming up.
Well, that'll be fine for now, thanks.
I have three good notes. I never seem to get to them.
Well, Miss Kaiser, we just don't have the time.
I can't leave.
What?
I can't leave. I'm sorry. I can't leave. I can't seem to let go of this lamp right now. You fellas go ahead. I'll be all right soon.
We got a crazy lady here, George.
Right up here. Thank you.
Ronnie, you want to give me the house lights, then you can go. Hello.
I feel like I just auditioned for the part of human being and I didn't get the job.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
See, it took me 3 weeks to get this audition. And I bought a new dress and I worked on my song. And I had my hair done, Mr. Max 2250, a work of art with lashes. And now I can't leave right away. I just can't leave right away. I will just have to hang around here for a while, see?
Fine. Fine. Sit where you are.
Thank you. I can't move anyway. My hand is stuck on this lamp.
Really physically stuck?
Yeah. Happens all the time. I get stuck onto things. Chairs, coffee cups, doorknobs, people. I'll be all right soon. Just don't shake hands with me or anything. You
You have kind eyes. It's funny to see your face after all that darkness. It's a nervous face, but kind eyes. Oh, God, I hate these auditions. I'm not what you're looking for. I'm not even Linda Kaiser. She's my roommate. My name is Allison Densmore. I never use it because it sounds so old, centuries old.
Well, it's a nice name. It's kind of graceful.
Sounds like a lot of doilies to me. It's very beautiful here with the lights on. This is a great set for Lucia de Lammermoor, Dawn on the Moors. I study opera every day an hour. You like opera?
Yeah.
I have them all in here. Opera's the best. People live at the top of their lives and die very beautifully. Lucia and Eduardo, they meet on this moor at dawn. She saves him in a way, but mostly he saves her from a wild bull, and she's crazy about him. But so they save each other. Listen to me, I'm still auditioning. All the time, I think I'm auditioning. I wake up in the morning and the whole world says, thank you very much, Miss Densmore. That'll be enough for now. I'm crying so hot, one eye at a time.
Hey, can I get you some coffee? Hmm? Something you like?
No, mostly I'd like to get my hand off this lamp. I have to go back to work soon. I'm a corporate librarian. That's a file clerk. With only 3 good notes, you have to back yourself up with something. I think I'll be able to get this lamp in a taxi. I'm crying from the other eye now.
These auditions, I don't blame you.
No, it's not the audition. It's not that.
Then why are you crying?
It's my birthday. I'm 34 years old today, and I'm not prepared. I'm prepared for 22. Right now, I could do a great 22. I woke up this morning, and all of a sudden, I was not young. I was not old, but I'm all of a sudden not young.
Sure, you're young.
Not young enough for this dress. Not young enough to be a corporate librarian with 3 good notes and a briefcase full of opera. Mister, I don't understand what happened to the time. All of a sudden, I'm going into my 10th year looking for a new apartment. I'm not much of a singer. And I'm not a gifted file clerk either. The one good thing I'm good at is being married. But my husband wasn't. That was 10 years ago. I've never learned another trade. The time, mister. It's not a thief at all, like they say. It's something much sneakier. It's an embezzler, up nights, juggling the books so you don't notice anything's missing. Hey, I let go of the lamp. Now I have your arm. Look at that.
You want to let go, can you?
Oh, I'm gonna teach you a ricky-ticky song. Kinda silly, but it ain't too wrong. Oh, you can't go wrong singing a ricky-ticky song. You just go ricky-ticky-ticky-ticky, ricky-ticky-ticky, ricky-ticky-ticky-ticky, ricky, come on. Ricky-ticky, ricky-ticky-ticky, can't go wrong singing a ricky-ticky song. Try it. You just go Scooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby, Scooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby, come on, Allison. Scooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby, it's a very cheery, cheery song. Scooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby, Scooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby-Dooby, oh, you can't go wrong with my ricky-ticky Scooby-Dooby song. You can't go wrong.
Can't go wrong.
Singing my song.
Singing my song.
Can't go wrong.
Can't go wrong.
Singing my song. Can't go wrong.
This thing really flies
by
itself.
All right. Can't go wrong. Singing my song.
Not to step on my mother. She lives in the linoleum and moans all night.
You make it all sound very attractive.
That's my routine. I make jokes. I make jokes because you'll be gone before I wake up and I'm gonna miss you.
How do you know that?
Because that's the way it goes. One of the few things I know is the way it goes.
Fact is, I will have to leave pretty early. My work.
I know your work, mister. You're an escape artist. And if I tell you I love you, you'll leave my bed in the rocket. But I know all that. So don't worry. Nothing dangerous will happen. There will be no loving. I promise you. You're safe. I was sitting on my fire escape this morning with my imitation citrus-flavored dietary beverage, thinking about dying. There's this man who types every morning. This woman who waters 6 geranium plants. They're right across the alley. They're there every morning like the sun. And I'm thinking, isn't it amazing how we're all gonna die? I mean, isn't it amazing? How we keep typing and watering geraniums and buying new dishes and we're all gonna die anyway? Then you took me up. You put the city in my hand. You're not gonna like this. But there was love in what you did. You'll leave tomorrow, but the feeling won't. And I thank you for it. This morning I was thinking about dying, and tonight I'm thinking about living. That's a very snappy birthday present.
pleasure to meet you, George.
How do you do?
Funny, this is how I first saw you.
What do you mean?
In the dark.
This for me. Chomsky, we gotta find him tonight.
Doctor, this tunnel, it doesn't seem to have an end.
That is correct.
So, if it's all the same to you...
I'm sorry, Mr. Soloway. But there's no beginning either. That will be 50 cents, please.
Carrots, some pickles. I'd like about 200 or 300 pounds of potatoes. Okay, thanks very much.
Hello, Pop.
Georgie, 5 a.m. Something wrong. What?
Oh, Pop, just wanted to talk.
Oh, what? 5 o'clock, what?
Restaurant.
Closed. It's 5 o'clock.
How come you're up?
I don't sleep good. How come you?
I don't sleep good either. We're on the telephone.
The vegetable market. I call in the order. Georgie, I don't see you now a long time. Heard the new tune. It's a crackerjack, believe me. Terrific. Go home. Go to sleep. Don't worry. A crackerjack.
Thanks, Tom.
Listen, I got terrific news for you. Last week I pushed you in the menu. I got them all in there, the greats from store business. Sandwiches named after them. And now you, Georgie.
Oh, thanks, Pop.
Well, what's new with you? How's business?
Business is good. You see Time magazine this time?
Time magazine, yeah, terrific, Georgie. Except what they had in the cover. They put gray in your hair.
Hmm?
Yeah, you got some gray in there. What else is new? How's Corey?
What do you mean, how's Gloria? We were divorced 5 years ago.
For a second, I...
Right, forget it. How's business with you, Pop?
New places opening in the neighborhood. Cheap places, cheap food. They grab all the lunch business. Nobody cares. Plastic tables, plastic food. Across the street now, they've got Eat-A-Rama, a monster. 94 tables. Can you imagine, Georgie, what they take in there one night, a place like that?
Christ's sake, Pop, why don't you move, expand, get a new restaurant? I mean, you keep sending back my checks.
I don't want them.
What the hell's the point? Take the goddamn money.
There's no point.
What do you mean?
Because I'm dying. I got something with the arteries, arterial something. It makes me talk foolish. I forget things like about Gloria. My head gets silly. I get days mixed up, sometimes years.
I didn't know.
Well, there's no point expanding at the present time.
Pop, I'm sorry. How do you feel?
Cheated. I had plans. Seems so fast. I'm very old, but it still seems fast. A finger snap, an appetizer.
Is there anything I can do?
Yeah. Queens Park Cemetery. Remember the name. Terrific place. Right across the river. Terrific view.
Talk about
it. I put your name on the menu. Got all the greats in there. Sandwiches named after them. The Jackie Gleason special. Johnny Carson salad. Sammy Davis. Merv Griffin. All of them I got in there. Now you.
Great. What am I?
You're a triple-decker sandwich.
Beautiful.
The Georgie Soloway triple-decker. Fresh thin sliced Novi, Golden Lake sturgeon, cream cheese, jives optional, sliced Bermuda onion, wow. Like toasted thick pumpernickel.
And a side of coleslaw?
Of course, with a side of coleslaw.
Ah, I'm immortal.
Sure. I go to sleep.
Goodbye,
Georgie. Margoris?
Thief.
Bandit, where's my dairy items? Soon starts the breakfast rush, and I'm sitting here without an egg.
Easy there.
Well, speak to your delivery man. Speak to your chickens. Because the grubs run out and the water's low, and we still got miles and miles to go till we get to San Antonio. Cactus cuts me, skeeters bite, coyote laughing out there in the night. Storm's coming up, so we better make camp. Oh, life ain't so simple for a saddle tramp. Oh, now, easy there, Sam, better take it slow, cause the grubs run out and the water's low. We still got miles and miles to go till we get to San Antonio. Oh, Sam, he's a good old horse. Almost blind, he don't know we're lost. When they find us, he won't give a damn. They'll say, just an old horse and a saddle tramp. Well, easy there, Sam. Better take it slow, cause the grubs run out and the water's low. We still got miles and miles to go. Still got miles and miles to go. Still got miles and miles to go. Still got miles to go.
Jesus, Queens Park Cemetery. Where the hell is that? Found it, Pop. Looks like a lot of little office buildings. Big place. Must be 50 acres. Can you imagine, Pop?
Can you imagine what they'd take in one night a place like that?
Skyphone operator 6, code 473, Soloway.
Skyphone operator 6, good morning.
Check information, Mrs. Ruth Charlton. Or a Dr. Charlton in Queens.
Dr. Bernard L. Charlton.
Yeah, sweetheart. Give me the residence.
Hello.
Who is this, please?
This is Danny Charlton. I like that.
Beautiful. Is your mother's name Ruthie? Ruth?
Yes. I just now waked up.
Great. May I speak to her, please?
Okay. Hello? Hello?
Hello, Ruthie. Hey, Ruthie.
Just who is this? Who's calling it?
Hey, Ruthie, it's me, Georgie.
Who is this, for God's sake? I can't hear you.
I'm sorry, Ruthie, I'm sorry.
Hello, is anybody there, for God's sake? It's 6 o'clock in the morning.
Ruthie.
Hello? Who is this? Speak loud.
Ruthie, the sky is full.
Hiya, crazy head. Ready for your ski lesson, Georgie?
Hiya, Doc, baby.
Snow's perfect today. Sorted work on your turns. Still haven't gotten the knack of the old turns, baby.
Speak to Allison first. Tell her I love her. I'm tired, Doc. So tired. Checked under the hood and I've been driving 1,000 miles without a motor.
This, please. Hello?
Who is this, please?
My name is Harry Kellerman. Harry Kellerman.
Hmm.
dancing fingers, skipping over the keys. Like the ears of butter, but gentle
with. Hey, Georgie. Today we're gonna try the 2 mile run, Georgie. Think you're ready, Nazi person?
Yeah, Doc, baby. Music is a mountain. Let us see how far we all can
the kisses of the girl who sings a song.